Welcome to a very loud Moody Coliseum on the hilltop here in SMU with Dallas. This is Sports Net National Sports Show. SMU and Tulsa. Lots on the line for this one. The American Athletic Conference champion, regular season championship is on the line. Both teams coming in this one is 14-3. Winner takes the title. And for SMU, if you recall, the selection committee turned it away, issued a stack of the deck, and winning the conference title adds more points in their resume and more likely gets them into the tournament. Personally, I think they've done enough to get in anyway. It's going to be a wild game. First time these two teams met, not that long ago, SMU dominated Tulsa. Today, James Hayes' team, and James Hayes, he knows a little bit about the winning championship. He's a great championship over at Missouri. Brains has been blank. Anyway, SMU and Tulsa. Big, big hoops weekend. And the Big 12 women's media. Big 12 women's basketball classic. And now you add this. Get ready to have some fun. SMU, Tulsa. And coming up later on, we're going to have day, so it'll be an emotional day for all. Get ready. SMU Tulsa, I'll be back to get the comments of Larry Brown. Special edition of the Donniesport Hoops Action Morning Show. You're checking it out right here on the...
post touches deeper. And I thought on offense, we were driving with some aggression, trying to cause some foul or contact. And we ended up, they ended up being tough shots because it allowed them to get, you know, get back in their transition game. So other than that, I'm really proud of how hard our guys competed. I thought we put ourselves, we played like a team, you know, one of the better teams in this league. And I'm really proud of that.
Thanks.
Dan, just talk about your shooting performance today. Outstanding.
I came in this game just focused, just ready to play. You know, the championship was on the line. You know, just trying to play to win.
All of your points came from behind the three-point range. Have you ever had a game in your entire life where you just hit everything from that far out?
Yeah, growing up, just shooting the ball, you know, I just wasn't worried about that, you know. I was just trying to make plays on my team, trying to stay in the game.
Did you sense any kind of adjustment
for SMU on you in the second half? They did an outstanding job defensively, as you can see, you know, they won the game. But, you know, my teammates was finding me. Shaquille was, you know, driving, putting pressure on the defense and kicking it out. I was able to knock down the shots.
What's the takeaway for you? Is it more kind of a special day of doing
that? You know, we fell short of the championship, but we played hard. I'm proud of my team. SMU is a very good team all around. Just losing it. Losing ain't fun, so, but hats off to SMU.
Coach, you seem like Brandon was frustrating Yannick and Marcus early in the game. What changed in that second half where they got some more touches and better looks down low?
You're asking me? Okay. Yeah, I think that was the difference. There was stretch there where they got a couple. We didn't do our work early. We were doing a great job with our execution defensive game plan. We know that was where their advantage was in the front line. Those four guys are outstanding players. And I thought for the most part our guys fought. But you look at the night Kennedy had and Cunningham, you know, 12 and 12. I mean, they're bigger, longer, more athletic than our guys, but I thought our guys fought hard.
As part of a conference championship team this year.
That's incredible. I say it all the time. When I got here, I didn't expect anything like this. Coach Brown came in his first day. He was talking about winning championships. And, you know, me and Ryan kind of sat there like, okay. But didn't really believe it. And now we're here. Couldn't ask for anything more.
Would you say that at what point did you guys start to believe that you wasn't just being smooth?
Our first year, we took a beating all year. And then last year, you know, Nate came in, Marcus, Nick, were able to play. And, you know, we had more talent. And obviously a great coach, and I think last year was when it kind of started turning around.
I'm guessing the standards changed a little bit when he got here. Was there ever a point for both you and Ryan where you were like, man, I don't know about this guy? You know, obviously the success from the past, where you were just going like, man, I don't know if I'm cut out for this. As the standards changed, you got to start to elevate.
I don't think the standards have changed since, like Kenneth said, since when he got here from day one, it's been high expectations. So that's not going to change. He's going to coach everybody hard. And treat everybody the same. So, I mean, that's not a change in what Coach Brown does, and I think that's helped us get to this point.
From the previous staff, where you're like, okay, this is different.
Oh, yeah, it was different, but, you know, it's all for the better.
Talk about the physicality of that game. It kind of got chippy.
That's what y'all need.
The game was not. I just let my emotions get to me. With my mom, made through my senior night, so I kind of get the thing on my head. But those two guys that helped me a lot with this game, so I appreciate you guys for that.
What would you say about the primary difference between this year's team and last year's that may have hopefully put you in a better position to get that NCAA tournament berth?
I'd say experience. We got everybody back. You've had a year under coach, and everybody knows what to expect.
Cam, can you guys rest easy on the tournament front?
No.
I'm not doing that.
last year happens differently, maybe that answer's different.
Yeah. I mean, I still believe we should have got in last year, but the only guarantee is to win this tournament coming up, so that's what we have on our plate now.
You guys kind of cleaned up a little bit of some of the little mistakes in the first half and limited their second chance points and all that. What was said in the locker room at halftime?
Nothing really. You know, like we've been here before. We've been in this situation plenty of times, and I think that's the difference from this year's team. I think when adversity hits us, we kind of fight through it. Last year, I don't think we did that too much. And so I think that's one of the main things. Coach Brown didn't really have anything bad to say at halftime. So we just, you know, all stuck together in the second half when we came out.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Go ahead.
Larry, the guys were just in here saying from day one, not this season, when you got here, it was championship. But you lose a normal in the summer, you lose Keith mid-year, you lose a couple other guys. Is there any point in the back of your head where you're going, man, I don't know about championship this year. There's a lot of stuff going on.
Well, I don't think we'd be sitting here with it, winning the championship without Matt's contribution. You know, he leaves me with Sean and Nick and Ryan and Emmanuel and Kevin. You know, those guys are pretty special kids. But when we got here, you know, I think we just felt with all the things SMU has to offer, you know, going in the Big East, you know, having this new facility in the works with all the terrific players, you know, in this area. We thought we had a chance to be good, but, you know, this year's been difficult. You know, I thought if we had Emmanuel, I think maybe Gonzaga gets us, but that's it. And he doesn't come and we don't have time to, you know, replace him. That was tough. And then losing Keith the way we lost Keith was, I still haven't gotten over that one. I still don't understand that one. Justin's situation was tough. So with all that happening, other guys had to step up. And, you know, that gave us a chance to win. And that makes it even more special, you know, when you have to fight adversity, because we didn't handle it very well last year. And, you know, on a Sunday last year, we found out we were going to play here. I think after today, I'm hopeful we don't have to play here till next year.
Give Cannon the start on the senior day, and he responds with 12-12 before fouling out. But talk about his play and Marcus's for that matter.
We've been starting Ben and Yannick, but all four of them, you know, I think deserve to play. There's no doubt in my mind, you know, we're not Kentucky or Wisconsin or teams like that with size, but our four guys, pretty darn good. I think we were all happy that Yannick and Cannon and Ryan could start. Even happier that they got to cut down the net, you know, last year, and hopefully set a standard for this program for a long time.
You said.
Yep, you're looking at it. SMU Mustangs men's basketball team, the American Athletic Conference champions, with a gritty 67-62 win over Tulsa today. Next up, it's the American Athletic Conference tournament up in Hartford, Connecticut. That's what SMU has on their agenda for this week. But I think they've done enough to make the selection committee who pieced together that 64-team playoff party notice. All eyes is on Big D and SMU right now. And once you get them in the tournament, I think they're going to turn some heads. I think they're going to do something. Buckle up. It's going to be fun. March Madness is here in the DFW and here on the Hilltop. Thank you for watching this special edition of the Donniesport Hoop Factory More Show from SMU. You saw confetti flying, twine being cut, and the SMU Mustangs winning the championship. More basketball action coming your way. Stay right here. Hoops extra and more on the Donniesport 17 Network.